हेलो एवरीवन, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर टॉपिक ट्रिग्नोमेट्री चैप्टर व्हिच इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर फॉर अस फॉर द क्लास 10 चैप्टर नंबर 8 अवर कंसेप्ट इज अ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री अवर कंसेप्ट इज अ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री ट्रिग्नोमेट्री इज अ मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन अवर मैथमेटिक्स सिलेबस एंड इट इज अ मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक ऑल्सो सो बिफोर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द ट्रिग्नोमेट्री कंसेप्ट वी आर गोइंग टू फर्स्ट you must know the types of the triangles. Types of the triangles. There are the four types of the triangles are. Number one, scalen triangle, then equilateral triangle, then right angle triangle, and last one, the isosceles triangle. The sequence of the naming of this triangle is not important. But its topic name, and that means the scalen triangle, equilateral triangle, right angle triangle, isosceles triangles. This categorization of the triangles or the types of the triangles depending on the sides and their sides relation means a triangle means a scalen triangle. Scalen triangle is a triangle whose sides are different from each other. Means no sides are equal. No sides are equal sides. Equal in length. Means scalen triangle is a triangle whose all the three sides are different from each other. That means their measurement is also different. Their length is also different. Such type of triangle is called as a scalen triangle. Such type of triangle is called as a scalen triangle. Means a triangle whose all the three sides are different measurements. There is a no equal measurements of the sides. Such a triangle is called as a scalen triangle. Now, if we consider among the three sides of the triangles, if the two sides are equal, all the three sides are equal. Then, if we consider a triangle whose all the three sides are equal in length, equal in measurement, such a triangle is called as an equilateral triangle. Such a triangle is called as the equilateral triangle. Means all the sides are equal. All three sides are equal. All the three sides are equal. Such a triangle is called as the equilateral triangle. Then scalen triangle means the no sides are equal. At least two sides are not equal in a scalen triangle. Then equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal. And another type is a right angle triangle. Another type is a right angle triangle. A triangle whose any angle having the measurement 90 degree. A triangle whose any angle having the measurement 90 degree. Such an angle triangle is called as a right angle triangle. Means if we consider the right angle triangle, I draw a small triangular figure here. If we consider the naming as A, B, C, then angle B means in a triangle ABC, angle B is equals to 90 degree. Then a triangle ABC is called as a right angle triangle. Sometimes what happened? Right angle triangle is also called as scalen triangle. Because triangle having the six component, three sides and three angles. Three sides and three angles. If the three sides are different, then the triangle having the all the angles are also different. Means the measurement of all the three angles are different to each other. Then equilateral triangle. What is the definition? Equilateral triangle is a triangle whose all the three sides are equal. All the three sides are equal. Such a triangle is called as the equilateral triangle. And if a triangle having the all the three sides are equal, then those angles having also having the all the three angles are also equal. That means each angle measurement is equals to 60 degree. That means if you consider the term equilateral triangle, means all the three sides are equal and all the three angles are also equal and their measurement is 60 degree. 60 degree. Third one is a right angle triangle. For a right angle triangle, triangle having the six component, all the three sides and three angles. Forget the side. Just concentrate on the angles. For a right angle triangle, all the three angles and among the three angles, one angle having the measurement is equals to 90 degree. And remaining two, their sum is also 90 degree. A triangle having the angle 90 degree, such a triangle is called as a right angle triangle. And the last one, if a triangle having the all the two sides are, sorry, among the three sides, any two sides are congruent or the any two sides are equal, then such a triangle is called as the isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. That is the basic part for the trigonometry. Triangle is a geometrical concept. Among the types of the triangles, we have seen that the scalene triangle, equilateral triangle, right angle triangle, and the isosceles triangle. For among these four, just use the trigonometric concept all on the right angle triangle. Means, use the trigonometric concept, trigonometric ratios, trigonometric identities, and the relationship only for the right angle triangle. When there is a right angle triangle, then the trigonometric concept is useful. Understand? This is the basic concept. Not necessary, must know. But for if you are going to learn the trigonometric concept, you must know the basic. And the basic of the trigonometric concept is from the right angle triangle. Okay? Then, if you consider the right angle triangle, for the right angle triangle, firstly, we draw the figure. Consider this right angle triangle, giving the naming as A, B, C. Then angle B is equals to 90 degree. For a triangle A, B, C, angle A, B, C is equals to 90 degree. Then triangle ABC having the angle B is equals to 90 degree measurement. And there are the two remaining angles, angle A and angle C. Both of the sum is also 90 degree. This is the right angle triangle. For a right angle triangle, we use the Pythagoras theorem. It is the concept in a class 8. But now our concept is a trigonometry concept. Then, for the trigonometric ratios, if we consider the trigonometric concept, then there is a trigonometry ratios. Trigonometry ratios are sine, number 2 cos, number 3 tan, number 4 cot, number 5 sec, and number 6 cosec. Means for a triangle ABC, we have to consider that the angle C is equals to theta degree. For angle ACB is equals to theta degree. In a triangle ABC, angle B is equals to 90 and angle C is a theta. If you consider theta is a measurement. Just then trigonometric concept sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, and the cosec theta. Means sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, and cosec all are the trigonometric functions. Understand? Then there are the total trigonometric ratios. Functions are 6. Among the 6 functions, there are the two types of categories. Means sine and cos, it is also called as the basic trigonometric functions. While tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, and the cosec theta is called as the derived trigonometric functions. It is called as a derived trigonometric functions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 6. 6 are the trigonometric functions. Among the 6 trigonometric functions, there are the two types of categories. One category is the basic trigonometric functions. Basic trigonometric function is also called as the parent trigonometric. And derived trigonometric function is also called as a child trigonometric. Then, if we consider total 6 trigonometric functions, among the 6, there are the two types of categories. Means, basic trigonometric function include the both functions sine and cos theta. And derived trigonometric function are those functions that is the tan, cot, sec, and cosec. Means, tan, cot, sec, and cosec are the derived functions with the help of the basic using the sine and cos. We will see later on this part. And there are the for the 6 trigonometric function, we are making these three pairs. One pair is a sine and cos. Another pair is a tan and cot. And third one pair is a sec and cosec. These are the means total trigonometric function 6. Category wise, there are the two groups, basic and derived. And third one, there are the three pairs, pairwise functions, sine, cos, tan, cot, and sec and cosec. This is the basic of the trigonometric functions. Understand? Means Trigonometric part is only useful when there is a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle is nothing but the one of the type of the triangles. From the scalen triangle, equilateral triangle, right angle triangle and isosceles triangles. Scalen triangle, equilateral triangle and isosceles triangles, these are the definitions of the triangle based on the sides. But right angle triangle is also the type of the triangle, but depends on the angular value. Means a triangle whose maximum measurement of any angle is equal to 90 degree, such a triangle is called as a right angle triangle. Students, our next topic is the trigonometric ratios. Before taking this topic, we just discuss about the some topics are related to the right angle triangle. Here triangle ABC is a right angle triangle because angle ABC, that is the measurement of the angle B, is equal to 90 degree. Means for the triangle ABC, this is the triangle ABC. In this triangle, the angle B, its measurement is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, triangle ABC is called as the right angle triangle. In this triangle, side AB and side BC are perpendicular sides. Means side AB perpendicular to the side BC. And side AC is a opposite side to the angle B. Therefore, side AC, or simply AC, is a hypotenuse. AC is a side opposite to the 90 degree. Means in a right angle triangle, hypotenuse is a side which is opposite to 90 degree angle. Therefore, in a triangle ABC, AB and BC are the perpendicular sides, and AC is a hypotenuse. Now consider the measurement of the angle C is theta degree. Now we have to consider or to learn the ratios of the trigonometric ratios. There are the 6 trigonometric ratios: sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec. And we have to find out the ratios with relate to the right angle triangle. So trigonometric ratios are number one sine theta. Theta is an angular value of an angle C. Means if we consider the angle C and whose measurement is equal to theta degree, just like that, if you consider the angle B and measurement of the angle B is equal to 90 degree. So here 90 degree and theta is the angular value, and whose angle is angle B and angle C respectively. Understand? Then our first ratio is a sine theta, and their formulation is sine theta is equal to opposite side to angle C upon hypotenuse. Means here if you consider this is the angle C, then its opposite side is, this is the AB side. So therefore opposite side to the angle C is a AB upon, which one is the hypotenuse? AC is a hypotenuse. Means for the first ratio is a sine theta, and whose formulation is for the sine theta, opposite side to the angle C, which is the opposite side AB, and BC is the adjacent side. Yes. Then AB is the opposite side to the angle C. So therefore opposite side to the angle C is AB, and upon their ratio is the hypotenuse, therefore AC. So if we consider the first ratio sine theta, then what is the formulation for the triangle ABC? AB upon AC. AB upon AC. Number two, cos theta. Number two, cos theta means adjacent side to angle C upon hypotenuse. Now consider the angle C. Just like that, AB is a opposite side to the angle C, then the for angle C there are the two adjacent sides. One of the side is the BC and second one side is the AC. But among these two adjacent sides, we consider BC is the adjacent side because AC is already a hypotenuse. So BC is the adjacent side for the angle C. So in a second ratio formulation, adjacent side to the angle C, then we have to consider that BC upon and same hypotenuse is AC. And our third one ratio is tan theta. Then tan theta and whose formulation is opposite side to angle C upon adjacent side to angle C. What is the formulation of the tan theta? Opposite side to the angle C upon adjacent side to the angle C. So if we consider the angle C is equals to theta, which one is the opposite side AB and upon which one is the adjacent side BC. Tan theta is equals to opposite side to the angle C upon adjacent side to the angle C. So therefore AB upon BC. And the fourth one ratio is a cot theta. Then what is the formulation for the cot theta? Just reverse or the inverse of the tan theta formulation. So adjacent side to angle C divided by opposite side to angle C. What is the formulation for the cot theta? Adjacent side to the angle C upon opposite side to the angle C. If we consider the angle C, then BC is an adjacent side. That means BC upon AB. That means here tan theta and cot theta are inverse of each other. Here tan theta and the cot theta are inverse of each other. Just concentrate. What is the formulation for the tan theta? Opposite side upon adjacent side. And what is the formulation for the cot theta? Just opposite to the tan. That means adjacent upon opposite side. So their formulation is totally opposite to each other. So tan theta and cot theta are inverse of each other. When you are taking the concept interrelation formulation of the trigonometric ratios or the trigonometric functions, that thing we have decided the same concept again, means tan theta and cot theta. But now this is the ratio and their formulation according to the sides of the triangle, adjacent, opposite and the hypotenuse, considering the any angular position. Fifth one ratio is a sec theta. Look at here. There are the six functions. Five already written on the board. And sixth one is a cosec theta. There is a no need to highly memorize or the learn this formulation. Just you remember or memorize the tact. What is the formulation? In this formulation, now three formulas, sine, cos and tan. This is the basic formulation. And after that, formula number 4, 5, 6, that is the cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta, which are the inverse of above mentioned formulation. What about? Means tan theta and cot theta are totally opposite to each other. Same as cos and sec. Cos and sec. What is the formulation for the cos theta? Adjacent side to the angle C upon hypotenuse. Upon hypotenuse. Then, what is the formulation for the sec? Sec theta is nothing but the inverse of the cos theta. Inverse of the cos theta. Means, sec theta and their formulation is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse upon adjacent side. Adjacent side to angle C. Adjacent side to the angle C. That means, which one is the hypotenuse? AC. Upon, and which one is the adjacent side to the angle C? BC. So therefore, sec theta is equals to AC upon BC. AC upon BC. Now similar, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta. There is also relation between the sine theta and cosec theta. Sine theta and cosec theta. Cosec theta is also nothing but the inverse of the sine theta. And what is the formulation for the sine theta? Opposite upon hypotenuse. Then the formulation for the cosec theta is hypotenuse upon opposite side to angle C. That is, hypotenuse is nothing but the AC and opposite side is AB. That is the formulation, that is the trigonometric ratios in terms of the right angle triangle. When we consider the any angular value, any angle of the right angle triangle, which are the formulations? First one is the sine theta, opposite side to the angle C upon hypotenuse. That means AB upon AC. That means AB upon AC. Which one is the second one? Cos theta. What is the formulation? Adjacent side to the angle C upon hypotenuse. I just repeat the one point again. If we consider the angle C, there are the two sides which is adjacent to the angle C. One of the side is AC and the second one side is a BC. But among these two sides, AC and BC, we consider the only adjacent side is a BC because AC is already a hypotenuse. So for the cos theta, adjacent side to the angle C upon hypotenuse, and we consider the BC upon AC. BC upon AC. Third one is the tan theta. Then tan theta and their formulation is opposite side to the angle C upon adjacent side to the angle C. If we consider the angle theta, then which one is the opposite side? AB. And which one is the adjacent side? Means AB upon BC. That is the formulation for the tan theta. Sin theta, cos theta and tan theta are the basic formulation. Now remaining the ratios are cot theta, sec theta and the cosec theta, which are inversely mentioned in above formulation. That means cot theta is the inverse of the tan theta. What is the formulation of the tan? Opposite upon adjacent. So cot theta is the inverse of tan. So therefore formulation of the cot theta is adjacent upon opposite side. Adjacent upon opposite side. So whatever be ratio for the tan theta, then this ratio of the tan theta, if we consider as an inverse, automatically it will be a cot theta. Thus therefore cot theta is equals to adjacent upon opposite, therefore BC upon AB. Similarly, if we consider the sec theta is nothing but the inverse of the cos theta, and the formulation for the sec theta is hypotenuse upon adjacent side to the angle C. So AC upon BC. And the last one ratio is the cosec theta. For the cosec theta, what is the formulation? Hypotenuse upon opposite side to the angle C. So hypotenuse is AC and opposite side then AB. So therefore ratio is AC upon AB. This is the ratio of the trigonometric chapter. Understand? So this is very easy to understand. Very also easy for memorizing this formulation. Just you must know the triangle. Any triangular value which is to be considered, that is the way, if we consider angle C is equals to theta degree, and according to the position of the angle which you have to take on, just concentrate on the which one is the opposite side, which one is the adjacent side and which one is the hypotenuse. It is a very nice concept in the class 10 syllabus. Trigonometry is an interesting part. Bas means you must know the basic part of the trigonometry. You just recall the formulation of the trigonometry. If you know the formulation of the trigonometry, then examples are very easy. Examples are very easy to calculate. Also, examples are more interesting. Now, our next concept is the trigonometric ratios formulation. That means the formulation of the sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, and cosec theta using the same trigonometric functions. Using the same trigonometric functions. Now, sine theta, cos theta, both are the basic trigonometric functions. There are the six trigonometric functions. Among the six trigonometric functions, there are the two category wise functions, which are the sine theta and cos theta, is called as the basic trigonometric functions. Basic trigonometric functions are the parent trigonometry. And whereas tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, and cosec theta, all these four functions are the derived functions. That means tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, and cosec theta, these formulas are derived by using the these two basic functions, sine theta and cos theta. So, what is the formulation for the tan theta? Means sine theta upon cos theta. Sine theta upon cos theta. Means, what is the formulation for the tan theta? Sine theta upon cos theta. And before some time, I already told to you that sine theta, cos theta, tan theta are the basic trigonometric formulations. Basic trigonometric formulation. Just concentrate on my words. If we consider the trigonometric functions category wise, then sine and cos are the basic functions. But when we consider these formulations concept, then sine theta, cos theta, and tan theta are the basic formulations. And cot theta, sec theta, and cosec theta are the inverse. Above mentioned formulation. That means tan theta's formulation is the sine theta upon cos theta, then tan theta is the inverse of the cot theta is the inverse of the tan theta. That means cot theta is equals to 1 upon tan theta. And what is the formulation for the cot theta? Cos theta upon sine theta. Cos theta upon sine theta, because 1 upon, after putting the value of the tan theta, means 1 upon sine theta upon cos theta. When in terms of the reciprocals, numerator having the fraction, denominator having the fraction, means numerator and the whole divided by denominator, denominator is also fraction. When we reciprocalize this term, when taking the inverse, then this denominator is totally inverse. That means the denominator of the denominator part, which is in multiplication with the numerator. So that means this cos theta is in upper side, that means in numerator, and sin theta is also in denominator. Therefore, 1 upon tan theta is equal to cos theta upon sin theta. And sec theta is called as the reciprocal of the cos theta. That means sec theta is equal to 1 upon cos theta. 1 upon cos theta. And cosec theta is 1 upon sin theta. That means tan theta and cot theta are reciprocal to each other, and sec theta is also reciprocal to each other. That means sec theta formulation is 1 upon cos theta. Means sec theta is the inverse of cos. Similarly, at the same time, cos theta is also reciprocal of the sec theta. So therefore, formulation of the cos theta is 1 upon sec theta. 1 upon sec theta. Just like that, cot theta, sec theta. Cosec theta is also the reciprocal of the sine theta. At the same time, sine theta is also reciprocal of the cosec theta. So these are the interrelationship formulation of the trigonometric ratios. What is the formulation? Sine theta is equals to 1 upon cosec theta. Sine theta is equals to 1 upon cosec theta. Cos theta is equals to 1 upon sec theta. Tan theta is equals to sine theta upon cos theta, and tan theta is also reciprocal of cot theta, therefore 1 upon cot theta. Just formula here and there, you must understand this. Then what is the formulation for the cot theta? 1 upon tan theta, and also cos theta upon sine theta, and sec theta is equals to 1 upon cos theta, and cosec theta is equals to 1 upon sine theta. These are the formulations. This is the formulations. And means first topic is the to understand the trigonometric ratio, you must know the right angle triangle and their given values. Means which are the perpendicular sides, what is the hypotenuse, which angle is equals to 90 degree. After that, if you consider the any angular value, we consider as a theta, then write down all the trigonometric ratio in terms of the angle theta. That means if you're calculating the angular value theta, then you must know the you must consider the angle C. Then we write down the formulation of the in terms of the sides, opposite side, adjacent sides. After that, we just recall this formulation, that is the interrelation formulation or the trigonometric ratios formulation. Means formulation of all these six trigonometric ratios using the trigonometric functions. So this is the basic part of the trigonometric chapter. Understand? This is the basic part. Yes, student, you just studied this concept of the trigonometry. Try to solve the some examples. Read the whole concept in your textbook. And after that, if you have any doubt, any queries, any confusions, or any not understandable parts, so comment this part to the my personal WhatsApp number, or you just comment this your queries in just below the comment section of this video. Understand? Okay, so this is the concept of the trigonometry. In the next part, we are going to cover the examples which are depends upon this concept, that means the ratio.